everyone, this is a Facebook ad setup tutorial for Shopify store. I'll show you how to set up a Facebook ad account and install the Facebook pixel on your Shopify store to keep track of different events step by step. Before we get started, you need to have a Shopify store up and running and a Facebook account. Step 1. Create a Facebook Business Manager account.
Visit business.facebook.com. Log into your Facebook account first and click Create Account. Enter your business name, account name, business email, and click Submit. Then you need to go through the email verification.
Step 2. Set up a Facebook ad account.
Go to Business Settings, choose Ad Accounts. Click Add and choose Create a new ad account in the drop-down menu. Enter the ad account name, time zone, and currency. Then click Next. Choose My Business when being asked who will this ad account be used for and click Create. Next, add people, set permissions, and click Assign. Finally, you need to add payment info. You may also do it later.
Step 3. Set up the Facebook pixel. You need to generate a Facebook pixel and properly install it to keep track of customers' interaction with your Shopify store. Here's how to set up a Facebook pixel.
Go to Events Manager, click Connect Data Sources, and select Web. Create a pixel, enter your store URL, and click Next to continue. Choose Pixel Only, and click Next. Then choose Use a Partner. Select Shopify to move on.
Step 4. Add the Facebook pixel to your Shopify store.
Copy the Facebook pixel ID. Head over to your Shopify admin. Choose Online Store. Preferences. Paste the Facebook pixel in the blank and save the settings.
Step 5. Set up Facebook marketing for your store.
Click the Add button next to Sales Channels. Choose Facebook in the pop-up window by clicking the green Add button. On the new page, click Update Sales Channel. Now you need to start setup of Facebook marketing. Connect your Facebook account. Enter your password to continue. Confirm to continue. And click Continue again. Then connect the Business Manager. Connect an ad account associated with your Shopify store. Click Connect. View and accept terms. Accept after you read through the terms and done to complete the process. Next, verify your primary domain. Take the box and click Confirm. Then, connect to the Facebook page associated with your store. Make sure to enable data sharing. Define your target country and read terms and conditions. So far, so good. Don't forget to update payment details. Here's what you should do. Check the location, currency, time zone, and click Save. Then, you'll be asked to add payment information. You can use PayPal. Just choose a way to pay. Click Continue. And the payment method will be added successfully. Once you've finished the setup, go to Settings, choose Data Sharing Settings, and you'll see three different options, namely Standard, Enhanced, and Maximum. No matter which one you choose, make sure to update your privacy policy by specifying that customers' personal data will be shared with Facebook to run relevant ads. Then, click Save on the top right. Finally, go back to confirm the change.
Step 6. Set up events to track conversions.
Go back to Facebook to confirm that you've completed the setup on Shopify and click Next. Now, enter your Shopify store URL to send test traffic and verify the connection. The final step is confirmation. You can take advantage of test events in Events Manager. Click View Events and you'll find that you still need to verify the domain. Facebook asks you to copy the meta tag and paste it into the code of the homepage of your Shopify store. Just go to your Shopify admin, choose Online Store, Themes, Actions, and click Edit Code in the drop-down menu. Find the file of the homepage code, paste the meta tag on the top, and click Save. Return to Facebook to click the Verify Domain button to complete the process. Now you're on the page of Web Event Configurations. Have multiple Facebook pixels. Make sure to use the right one to track events. Click Manage Events to edit these events. Select the right pixel for tracking. Once a change is made, you need to define the event again. Because you have so many standard events to choose from, resetting is easy. Finally, confirm the changes and click Apply. You can do so with another domain if you have any. Return to Events Manager. Refresh the page, and you can now move on to Test Events. Clear Activity. Enter your store URL and click Open Website. Just quickly browse your products. Add one to the cart. Go back and you can see all your activities tracked, including page view, view content, and add to cart.
Now that you properly set up your Facebook ad account, installed the Facebook pixel, and defined events, you can start creating promotions and Facebook ads. If you like this video, please give us a like, subscribe, and turn on the notification for more useful tutorials. Stay tuned!